Praise the Lord. We're here at WLJC, and this is a room where we answer the phones and try to help people get on a way that they need to get on. You know, I believe what will make it work is when people are downstairs singing and the people up here answering the phones. You know, the Bible said right there in Matthew 9:37, the field is white to harvest and the laborers are few. You know, I thank God for every one of you out there that's supporting WLJC, because this is a lighthouse up on a hill. God bless you and keep backing up WLJC in Jesus' name.
WLJC welcomes you to have church with us for the next 90 minutes during the hour of harvest. Call in your prayer request or praise report now. The WLJC prayer team is standing by to talk and pray with you. We have some very special musical guests here this evening to share in song the good news of the gospel. So sit back, relax, sing along, and join in with us as we pray for you and the needs of all our viewing audience. Hour of Harvest is touching countless souls from the Appalachian Mountains to the Bluegrass region, across the nation, and around the world. Live from our studios in Beattyville, Kentucky, here is your host of the Hour of Harvest, Margaret Drake.
Good evening and welcome to the service tonight. On a good cold night, just prop your feet up and pull up a blanket over you and get real comfortable and stay with us, because the weather outside's cold, but we're going to have some music that'll warm your heart and just cheer you up tonight, because that's what we need. You know, we have been blessed with a really light winter. We have not suffered at all with that, but we might get a little snow, they say. But anyway, as for tonight, we've got our mind on the Lord, and we want to remind you of the good things that He has for us. And right now, I want to read a few scriptures, especially for those that could not read today. And of course, so many times I go back to Psalms, because I love the Psalms. Psalms 105. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, call upon His name, make known His deeds among the people. And you know, that's what we try to do. We want to let you know what the Lord has done. We have a call in a while ago from Phyllis that was prayed for last night, and she was healed. This was after service. And so that's telling about the deeds of the Lord. Sing unto Him, sing psalms unto Him. Talk ye of all of His wondrous works. Glory ye in His holy name. Let the heart of them rejoice that seek the Lord. Seek the Lord and His strength. Seek His face evermore. Remember His marvelous works that He hath done, His wonders and the judgment of His mouth. O ye seed of Abraham, ye servants, ye children of Jacob, His chosen. He is the Lord our God. His judgments are in the earth. He hath remembered His covenant forever, the word which He commanded to a thousand generations. So just think, as long as time lasts here on this earth, His promises will still be true for our descendants, the ones that are coming after us. And you know, when you stop to think about it, if you have a family, the thing you want most of all is to know that they have a relationship, they're saved, they have a good working relationship with the Lord, and that they're going to serve Him. That would please you more than anything that could happen when you leave this earth, that to know that your family is going to carry on in believing the Lord and working for Him. And so His promises will be good for the generations to come, and because His word never changes, and it's so good. So tonight, As we think about the good things of the Lord, we have prayer requests already in, and we have a lot of good singing tonight. So we're going to pray and get into the singing, so we can have as much time as possible for that. Folk brave enough to come out in this kind of weather to share with us, we're thankful for that. Let us pray right now. Father, in Jesus' name, we thank You that Your promises will be to all of the generations to come. And we thank You for how they have been true and alive and well for the ones before us. We are experiencing the same thing, that your words are true and you stand by them. You watch over your word to perform it. We thank you for that. And so tonight, Lord, as we go into this service, we ask for your blessing on the singers and on the phone operators and on the ones that will be joining us, regardless of where they're from. We know many hospitals, nursing homes, and jails and so forth, they view this program. Lord, you're the only thing that will bring satisfaction and contentment to them. So let it happen tonight. Bless each person that is going to be with us in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, tonight we have two singing groups. So the first to sing for us is the Allens. That's Emil and Karen from Jeffersonville. And their phone number is 859-498-9445. And they're from the Free Will Baptist Church over there. So let's just go over right now and welcome the Allens.
I have no silver and no gold, no earthly mansions do I own, but I have peace, wonderful peace in my soul. I have no fear, what man can do, the Lord I serve will see me through. Someday, wonderful day, I'm going home.
WLJC with Margaret and Don and all these camera people. They're just like family. We've been over here quite a few times. And I'm looking forward to that day I'm going home. I started out 57 years ago to go home, and I'm still on the road. And I'm going to make it one of these days. We're glad to be here. You pray for us while we're here. We're here for one reason. That's to see somebody saved and get out the word of Christ. And we're to spread the gospel throughout the world. And it's a good way to spread it in songs. And if you listen to the words, not the way I sing. Karen's a good singer, but I can't sing good. I just feel in a little bit. So you pray for us real hard. Our next song is going to be that Glad Reunion Day. Amen.
Lord, on the beds and hilltops with hearts all aglow. That will be a glad reunion yon day.
The fact, what a day that's going to be.
That's right.
One old writer told us when his son passed away, and he said, well, can't bring him back, but I can go be with him. We can't bring none of these folks back that we've loved down through years, moms and dads and children and aunts and uncles and brothers and sisters, but if Lord's will, we'll be with them when this life is over. If I don't go for too long, I'm still a winner. I'm a winner either way. Amen.
I'm a winner.
Lose, you're on a winning team. I know there's been so much excitement about these lotteries and all these things, people buying all these tickets, and their kids probably hungry at home, needing clothes and all these things. But if you serve the Lord, you're a winner either way. This song says, keep walking. You got to keep walking, you got to run, and you just got to stay in step with the Lord. Amen. Excited when I feel the presence of the Lord. Some of these songs is they'll make glory bumps on you. Do you know it? Mm-hmm. They just make glory bumps all over you. You feel the presence of the Lord. Karen's going to sing one.
Okay, I wanted to send out a couple of dedications. I've run into some people just here and there and everywhere, and there's so many that we don't even know their name, but several have given me their name. Bud and Patsy Powell from Clay City, Carl and June Banks from Winchester, and I know some people at work will be watching tonight. Sharon and Barb will be watching tonight, so I know they're working, so, but anyway, I just want to put out those dedications to them, and it's
also
just good to be here.
Let me say this. I watched a rerun of Us in the Choir the other night on TV, and when it went off, I got four phone calls, and there's one lady especially. She was Alan, and no relation for it, I know, but we talked a long time. I had a real good talk, and I told her I'd mention her. She said, remember her and her family, and the whole family needed prayer. So this is that Sister Allen that I talked to the other day. And I like to send it out to my brothers that's been sick. Both of them, one's in car wreck, one with cancer. And they're both getting along pretty good now. My sister, Eileen, that lives in Winchester. So help is on the way. I'm glad for that.
Sent Elisha to make his word.
Help is on the way. I don't care how much trouble you get into, if you look to the Lord, help is on the way. And what need no message here. I'd like to send this out also to the folks at the church where we go in Camargo, Free Will Baptist, Brother McIntosh, our pastor, and Brother McIntosh lost his wife some time ago, and we still want you to remember him in prayer. And also all the folks are in the church. We'll send this next song out to them.
When burdens come so hard to bear that no earthly friend can share, tears drive away the smile and leave my heart in pain. Lord, from heaven above, speaks to me in tones of love, wipes the tears away and makes me smile again. I need no mansions here below, for Jesus said that I could go to a home beyond the clouds, not made.
Don playing with us here tonight.
Sounds good.
I think it's an honor to be in his presence, where he can pick anything that's got a string on it. And some things that don't have strings on it. Yeah, I believe he can play them too. Amen. Praise the Lord. We love Don and Margaret. We've been with them a long time. They've even stopped over home and we've eat together and I just learned to love them. All these folks here, these camera people, and everybody works here. They're just like family. We're going to sing, Will This Circle Be Unbroken?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Will the circle be unbroken? remember all of it. In the sky, he said, I go away and prepare a place for you, and if I go, come again. So he's coming back, Don. Those that found the rock and built on the rock. Amen. Here's a song I wrote a long time ago. That's Brother Love Bessie.
We're not doing that. We'll go to the next page.
I'll go to the next page, she said. Amen. Oh, yeah. And, all right, here's a good song. I think everybody that sings has sung this song sometime or other. Family Circle.
Memories of my
Amen. Songs about heaven. Praise the Lord. There's going to be a big reunion in heaven one of the days. Amen.
Forever will be, and the crown he
place. Bible said, eyes not seen, ears not heard, neither is it into the hearts those who love him. This natural body couldn't stand to look on heaven, how beautiful and wonderful it's going to be. Jesus was the carpenter. He said, I'm going to prepare a place for you. Going home. There's another song that says something about going home. We must have going home on our minds. It's a beautiful song. We sing this in the choir sometimes. Been in church.
Yes.
Just any day now. Yeah, that's good. Well, he said he's coming back. The writer of this song said just any day now. He could come any day. Amen.
Signs of his appearing everywhere.
right. Thank you so much. The Allens, Emil and Karen from Jeffersonville, Kentucky. And they have a phone number, 859-498-9445. And if you'd like to contact them, I'm sure, let them know you appreciate them coming tonight. And we appreciate them braving it in this cold weather. Because, but it's a good chance to be visit with you, and that's what they want to do. They, Brother Emil's been in the ministry for a long time, so he's sung and preached to a lot of people, and so we're glad to have them tonight. All right, we have another guest singer tonight, and she's going to make her way up to sing for us, and this will be her first time here. And I believe that's right, first time. All right, and her name is Cheryl
Herndon.
Okay, Herndon. Okay, got it. And she's from Frankfort, Kentucky, so she's driven a long way, and she's from the Cornerstone Church of the Nazarene. Her phone number is 502-382-6621. So let's welcome Cheryl right now.
Let me first say thank you, Miss Margaret, for allowing me to be here. And it is a pleasure to be here. And I just pray that God will let me do what I need to do.
Ever.
This next one's one of my personal favorites. I am weak, but thou art strong. Jesus, keep me from all wrong. Just a closer walk with thee. Grant it, Jesus, is my plea. Daily walking close to thee. Let it be, dear Lord. Let it be. Through this world of toil and snares, if I falter, Lord, who cares? Who just a closer walk with thee. Granted, Jesus, is my plea. Daily walking close to thee. Let it be, dear Lord, let it be. When my feeble life is o'er, time for me will be no more. God, to thy kingdom sure, to thy shore. Just a closer walk with thee. Granted, Jesus, is my plea. Be, dear Lord, let it be. Silver land, I've got
discouraged. I'm heaven bound. I'm just a pilgrim in search of a city. I want a mansion up in a crown. I've got a mansion just over the hilltop in that bright land where we'll never grow old.
Something we all need to do.
I'm only human. I'm just a woman. Help me believe in all that I am and what I could do. Show me the stairway I have to climb. Lord, for my sake, teach me to take one day at a time. One day at a time, sweet Jesus, that's all I'm asking from you. Just give me the strength to do every day what I have to do. Yesterday's gone, sweet Jesus, and tomorrow may never be mine. Lord, help me today, show me the way, one day at a time. Do you remember when you walked among men? Well, Jesus, you know, as you're looking below, it's worse now than then. Cheating and stealing, violence and crime. Lord, for my sake, teach me to take one day.
This one's an oldie but a goodie. That's what I call it anyway.
Out the news, I know. and fell. Oh, was that someone new? You may have longed for added strength, your courage to renew. Do not be disheartened, for I bring hope to you. It is no secret what God can do, what He's done for others, He'll do for you. Just take Him at His promise. Don't run away and hide. It is no secret what God can do, what He's done for others, He'll do for you.
I just want to say, you know, it is no secret what God can do. He can do anything. And no, I forgot where I was going with that, so I guess we'll just go on to the next song. I know what I was going to say. He's faithful to us even when we are unfaithful to Him. Just across the Jordan River, there is a place of everlasting joy and peace, where the tree of life is blooming there forever. A crown of life is waiting there for me. Now that sounds like home to me, like where I want to be. There'll be no tears to fear. The hills will echo with His story as we sing of His grace and glory, where the saints of God will be. That sounds like home to me.
say there's mansions there inside that city. And a crystal river flows right by the Tree of Life. There be no pain or disappointment there to hurt us. And Jesus Christ Himself will be the light. And that sounds like home to me, like where I want to be. There'll be no tears to fill our eyes again. God will be. That sounds like home to me. That sounds like home to me, like where I want to be. There'll be no tears to fill. Of God will be. That sounds like home to me.
Well, I've been doing some slow ones. We're going to speed it up now.
Early one morning, I stepped out the doorway, stopped to look up to the sky, thinking that this may be the exact day that Jesus would sound forth His cry. There was nothing but blue skies with one little white cloud slowly slipping along. Well, I got so excited that I shouted out loud, this may be the cloud He's coming back on. This may be the cloud He's coming back. Learning point to His returning, and I got a longing for home. I keep my eyes on the sky, ready to fly. When you see the clouds slipping along, you'll get so excited that you shout it out loud. This may be the cloud He's coming back on. Troubles get you down, leave your sorrows behind. Step outside, take the time to look all around, and keep your eye on the sky and get ready to fly. When you see the clouds slipping along, you'll get so excited that you shout it out loud. This may be the cloud He's coming back on. This may be the cloud He's coming back on. Oh, we all know that it's not long. Signs of a learning point to His returning, and I got a longing for home. I keep my eyes on the sky, and I do what He trumpet will sound and I lift up the ground to declare that he's coming back on. Gabriel's trumpet will sound and I lift up the ground to declare that he's coming back on.
All right. Thank you so much, Cheryl from Frankfort, Kentucky. She's driven a long way to be with us tonight. Her phone number is 502-382-6621. And we appreciate her coming tonight to help us. All right. Karen and Emil are such good workers, and when they come, I really like to work them. All right, and I'm going to let you get the privilege of reading these. You see what the yellow part up there is about.
Salvation.
Right.
For the family of called in Mitzi, Madison, pray for her family, self-finance, 7 children. They were saved tonight.
Yes.
Yeah. Right. Praise the Lord.
Yes.
Amen. And here's another one saved. Called in by T-R-E-A-D-Y Trady from London, Kentucky. You can make it out.
Well, let's see. What? Okay. Well, I'm not sure. That must be some of Cecil's writing.
We'll lay that on Cecil.
Well,
okay.
Yeah. Well, he's not down here to defend himself.
From London, Kentucky.
But she got saved. Is the thing.
She got saved.
Yeah, that's
and,
a
amen.
That's
you can't hardly make out Cecil.
Yeah.
But anyway, let's pray for her.
Yes.
She broke her back. So she really needs prayer and got saved. That's wonderful.
Yes,
that's two.
That's the victory report.
Amen.
All right. Here's one from Estill County, a prayer request for mom and dad and sister and wanted to hear Amazing Grace. And now Karen, Karen's a nurse and she can read and talk at the same time. So read to us.
Well, let's see what I can do. A grandmother called in for her grandson from Floyd County, is needing to have some surgery. And I've read through all of them. We may not get all of them because there's several here. Phyllis is having cataract surgery in the morning. And she wants Sister Margaret and them to know that she prays for them every night. So that's good. We need the prayers. Mm-hmm. Marlene called in for her cousin, real bad off in the ICU. And it's an urgent prayer request at this time. She's very critical. Merla in Beattyville. Betty Sparks is in Central Baptist. Nellie Wooten called in for Claude and Billy. Several things going on there with cancer and needing a liver transplant and several things. Roger from Madison called for Alicia, Kevin, and Madeline for an unspoken request, as well as for Corey and Tiffany. Juanita from Clay also has an unspoken request. God knows these things.
Yes, He does.
Amen. You know, in our inner being of ourself, when we talk to God, He knows what every prayer request is for.
Amen.
So, and if we have a desire that we want to see something done, all we have to do is pray and ask and believe, and the Lord will supply that.
Yes.
Maybe
it's
a financial need. Maybe it's just a health need. Any of those that can be taken care of by the Lord. Someone called in from Somerset. Frank from McGoffin needing prayer. Goldie from Montgomery. Her and Earl both are ill. A friend in Morgan County called for Joyce from Pulaski for Mark and Debbie. In Floyd County for Emma and the family. Marcella from Laurel, stomach and chest pain. So there's just so many. Mary from Burnside having tests done and hoping that those will turn out well. Donald from Somerset for Rebecca, been going through some rough times, and these are rough times.
Yes.
For people. We see it each and every day. Hazard calling in for Johnny with cancer. Jeff from Clay. something about some blood tests, and they're hoping that those turn out well. Madison County, they're on drugs and they need prayer there, need to get off of those drugs. Owsley, Billy from Owsley, Marvin has cancer. Tony has called in, pain in his body and hurting in the back. Jackie from Floyd, calling in for Linda, Pastor Louie, and Richard. Her friend has throat cancer. Miss Ludine from Jessamine is also ill and wants Dr. Jesus to heal her.
Mm-hmm.
So, that's right. Take it to the right person. Nicole from Lee has prayer requests and needs for Jenny, Nadine, and Laura. Bertha from Madison, praying for herself and family. A woman called in for Linda and Sally. Linda had a stroke and is in the hospital in Louisville. And Sally also had a stroke and is in a nursing home. Also pray for her son, Billy. Curtis from Scott is praying for, he's been sick. And he says, to God bless to everyone at WLJC, the Margarets, the group, and the workers, and everyone. A woman calling for Billy with an illness that needs to be touched. What I have here.
Amen.
All right. Thank you. Marie from Rock Castle has called for Jerry. He's home from the hospital right now, but he's still not doing well. And here's one for her husband that has COPD and other issues and wants healing and comfort. Robert from Knox for healing and for his neighbor and our country. Nancy for several folk there. And there are just several more here that we,
yes.
We're going to ask this couple to anoint these with oil, and they're going to lead us in prayer, and you know, they're going to lead us, but we're all going to join our faith with theirs, mm-hmm. and that's what makes such a big difference, is when there's prayers of agreement, you know, if you can... Anytime you're having a meeting or anything, the more you get to agree, the sooner it will be over. And so, all right, go ahead, lead us in prayer.
God, our Heavenly Father, we're so thankful to be here tonight.
Oh, Jesus.
Most of all for those two souls, Lord, that
yes,
came
Lord.
To you and got saved.
Yes.
That was our prayer, Lord.
Yes.
Even on the way over here tonight, Lord, we asked you to save some precious souls.
Yes.
That really need to be saved. And Lord, we thank you that it's happened. And God, we thank you for every good and perfect gift you bestow upon us. Now, Lord, these requests they read off, there's many needs in our Lord, many needs. And you know about each and every one. And there's not a one, Lord, that you can't fulfill. For you have all power in heaven and in earth. And we'd ask you, our Father, to look down upon each one of these, Lord, and heal according to thy will. You
yes,
said when you
yes.
pray that thy will be done
yes,
on earth
Lord.
As it is in heaven.
Yes.
And we know, Lord, that you're still in the healing business. You caused the lame to walk and the blind to see and the deaf to hear, and you even raised the dead. And we know, Lord, the Bible said you're the same yesterday, today, and forever. So we can just commit all these requests, Lord, into your hand and may God, your will be done through all these things. We ask it in your Son and our Savior, Jesus Christ. And amen, amen. Praise the Lord.
All right. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Well, we've had a lot of good singing here on this cold night, so I'm sure everyone has enjoyed that. Karen, do you have something you'd like to share?
I'm just glad to be here tonight and glad I'm a Christian and just so thankful that we have a place that we can come to, that
Amen.
We can worship the Lord in spirit and in truth. And I have felt the Spirit here tonight. The Lord was with
yes.
us as we were
yes.
singing. And
yes.
as we listened to Sister Cheryl, she did an excellent job. And we,
Amen.
You know, you have to have ones that will come out and work for the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
I'd like to do more here and in my church and even for the Lord. I'd like to do more. And that was one of my desires this year, is to do something more for the Lord that maybe I didn't do last year. Win another soul for the Lord. Mm-hmm. And we're just thankful for the station here and there's so many blessings that come through it, salvations and yes. prayers that are answered, and through it all, we can give it all the praise and honor to yes. Jesus Christ. There's no other yes. one that we can give it to, and that's the way I always want to feel, you know. I never want it to be me. I always want it to be for the Lord.
Yes.
And give
yes.
Him everything in my life. You can see things happening nowadays in this world that it just makes you cry. Mm-hmm. It makes you cry to think that there's things that's happening and things that are going on, but Satan is working hard. As mm-hmm. Brother Cecil and us were talking earlier, Satan is out to do a good job and mm-hmm. to take as many with him as he can. Mm-hmm. But it's our desire that all be saved and mm-hmm. come to the realization of the
yes.
Lord.
Yes.
And we can say at the end of our life that we've kept the faith, we've run the race, mm-hmm. and therefore it's laid up for us a crown of righteousness. If we have kept that faith
yes.
to the very
yes.
end, it's a race that you
yes.
run and you can't slack. I was looking through some songs today and it talked about, I'm just not going to make it through, but I want to know, and I'm going to make it through those doors.
yes.
Not just by the skin of my teeth, as some people say.
No.
I don't want it to be like that. I want to know in my life that
yes.
the Lord has saved me and set me on the right track.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm just thankful to be here.
Amen.
It's been a good place to be.
All right, that's great. All right, what would you like to share?
Amen.
We've got a little few minutes.
Paul said, I believe it was Paul said, I fought a good fight, finished the course. Henceforth there's laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord the righteous judge shall give me on
That's
that day.
Mm-hmm.
And not unto me only, but unto all those that love his appearing.
Right.
And I read in the Bible where hundreds and thousands were saved through Christ's 3.5 years tour in this world. And Paul been many places, and Peter, many of them, and souls were saved by the thousands then.
Mm-hmm.
The Bible said Jesus Christ the same yesterday, today, and forever,
mm-hmm.
and changeth not. So why aren't we seeing that today? We're seeing a lot of preachers in this big auditorium thing, people's coming down, and I trust and pray every one of them is saved.
Mm-hmm.
And he can save thousands today, just like
yes.
he did then.
Yes.
I know what the problem is. Zion's not travail. Said when Zion travails, sons and daughters will be born.
Mm-hmm.
Zion is the church, and we certainly need to draw nigh to God. And my theory is this: get right, live right, and die right, and everything will be all right.
Yes,
man.
Yes.
There's a place waiting
good.
For you. He said, I'm going to prepare a place for you. If I go, I'll come again, receive you unto myself. To where I am, there you will be also. I'm looking mm-hmm. forward, Sister Margaret and Brother Don,
yes.
to being with the Lord when this life
yes.
is over. We sang several songs about going home
mm-hmm.
and homesick for heaven
yes.
and these things, and I feel that way.
Mm-hmm.
I'm older than some of you put together. I'm not ashamed of it. I'm proud and thankful mm-hmm. to God. He's given me longevity of life.
Mm-hmm.
I'm 88 years old. Brother Bill here, me and him, he's
mm-hmm.
about 3 or 4 months older than me.
He's about to turn 89 next
yeah.
month. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I was 88 in August, and as far as I know, I'm ready to go meet the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
And I do know that I'm ready to go.
Yes.
Not as far
yes.
as I know, but I do know
yes.
that I'm ready to meet the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
I've had good times in these 57 years that I've served the Lord. I've had ups and downs and ins
right.
and outs and all
mm-hmm.
these things. I pastored for 40 years or over.
Mm.
And I've counseled people and talked to people with every problem you could think of. And I'm glad that I met you and Don and all these workers here.
Mm-hmm.
You're family to me.
Yeah.
You're family
yeah.
to
well,
me.
Thank you.
I'm too old to pastor. You see, I can't get around hardly.
Mm.
But I can sing a little bit with Karen. And she helps me out by lifting me
mm-hmm.
up during them
songs. Yeah.
I couldn't do without her.
Yes.
I thank God for her. She
yes.
waits on me
She's...
and takes care of me.
Yes.
I think the love bug struck her or something. I don't know.
But
anyway, I'm glad to be a Christian.
Yes.
Me and Don was talking a few minutes ago about going back. I believe, no, it was me and Cecil, I believe, talking about going back. A lot of people going back. I don't know what I'd go back to. 57 years ago, I found the Lord. Things are not like it was 57 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what I'd go back to, but I'm taking up too much time. I love the Lord, and I love you folks, and we'll be back over here in March.
All right.
March, the choir will be here in March.
All right.
All right, I'm glad to be here, and I enjoyed that sister back there, Cheryl.
Cheryl,
that's her name. I enjoyed those songs. It was really good. She done a wonderful job. Let's pray for her. She's got to drive all the way to Frankfort now.
Yes.
Amen. Good to be here.
All right. Thank you so much. Appreciate everyone that's helped in the service tonight and all of our staff. And so our time is up. So from all of us here in the studio, we want to say good night and God bless you.
Thank you for being a part of the Hour of Harvest. We hope you get a blessing every time you watch. This program is available for download on your computer or mobile device at www.wljc.com. WLJC is now available on Roku and Google TV. DVD copies of this program are also available for your contribution of $15 or more. The WLJC programs, including the Hour of Harvest, are brought to you through your contributions of support. All contributions made to WLJC are eligible for income tax deduction. Thanks to all who support us. Without you, our programming would not be possible. If you would like to join our mailing list to receive our free monthly newsletter to keep you informed